Today on Sports Central, we'll be going over a college football game preview and prediction on a big matchup coming up in Week 14, and this is going to be between the Florida Gators and the Tennessee Volunteers. Both these teams, of course, are on opposite sides of the spectrum right now. On Florida's side, of course, you got a 7-1 record. You're just outside of the college football playoff, and you've won 5 straight. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, they've lost 5 straight. They're 2-5, and they're on a 5-game slide trying to come back from a pretty bad deficit that they're at right now, and this is a Tennessee team that really does not have anything as far as momentum is concerned, and they're going to try to build some momentum back for at least the 2021 season at best. Meanwhile, for Florida, they're trying to keep their college football playoff hopes alive, which there's still a pretty big possibility right now for Florida, so this is a crucial game for them as well. We'll be going over a full game preview and prediction on this one here today, starting out with your team trends. And of course, Florida beat Kentucky last week. 34-10 was the final score there, so Florida had a good game against Kentucky. And the kind of the trend for Florida over the past few games is they've been starting slow against these teams, but however, I mean, in the second half, Florida's always been the team to take off, which, I mean, we saw that especially against Vanderbilt a couple of the weeks ago. We saw Vanderbilt lead a couple of times in the first half, and then Florida kept it close, but in the second half, they would just take off, and that's exactly what they did against Kentucky, same thing as Vanderbilt. So, and that's kind of been the trend for Florida right now, and that's the thing for Tennessee here is they're going to have to start fast, and they're going to have to keep pushing the pedal if they're going to want to beat the Gators here, which, I mean, this Florida team is a tough team to beat. You got Kyle Trask, who's, I would say, a top 3 quarterback in the nation right now. And all around, this Florida team is extremely talented this season, so it's going to be a tough team to beat. Winning streaks both these teams, though. Florida's ranked 6th in the nation as of the AP poll for Week 14. They're 7-1 with a 5-game winning streak. Tennessee is unranked 2-5 with a 5-game losing streak. So both teams, once again, are really on opposite sides of the spectrum right now as far as momentum is concerned. This game's going to be on Saturday, December 5th, 3:30 p.m. Eastern in Knoxville, so the Vols will be your home team here. Spread currently says Florida by 17. ESPN FPI's got Florida 85%. And the Vegas prediction is also going with Florida 38-21 being the current projected final score. So the Gators are favored in all three areas here, which really is not much of a surprise considering how Florida's been and the momentum that Florida has right now moving forward. Because, I mean, Florida got a loss, or they took a loss earlier on in the season to a really good Texas A&M team, which, I mean, Texas A&M is now ranked in the top 5, so obviously that wasn't too terrible of a loss. But ever since, I mean, they've been on a roll. I think Florida's genuinely gotten a lot better as the season's gone on, and that is certainly something that a lot of teams need to be afraid of, because Florida, I mean, Kyle Trask and this team is on fire right now, and I think, I mean, if they were to face Alabama today, which they probably will be for the SEC championship, I think Florida would give Alabama quite a fight at this point. Here's your stat comparison for this game. Florida's got 43 points per game, 25 points allowed. Got 369 pass yards a game, 139 rush yards, and then for yards allowed, they've got 243 passing and 143 rushing. As for Tennessee, kind of the opposite. They got 20 points per game, 31 points allowed. They got 184 pass yards a game, 155 rush yards. Then for yards allowed, it's been 243 passing and 161 rushing. So all around, I mean, for Florida on their side, like 43 points a game is an excellent stat, especially in the SEC. I mean, the SEC is a very defensive conference. Usually, you'll see a lot of good defensive teams in the SEC, which, I mean, you kind of see that out of some conferences. Like, that's the trend with the Pac-12. The Pac-12 is more of a moderate scoring conference. The Big 12 is more of a high scoring conference. And the SEC is more of a low-scoring conference due to great defenses. So for Florida to score an average of 43 points per game is pretty impressive. They also got 370 pass yards a game, which is great, out of Kyle Trask. Give him credit for that one. He's had a great season for Florida. I would consider him to possibly be the best quarterback in the nation, yes, above Trevor Lawrence right now. I mean, Trevor Lawrence is pretty good, but Kyle Trask, he needs to be considered as a very high pick in the 2021 NFL draft, because this season, through 8 games, he's put up 2,800 yards, 34 touchdowns, and 3 interceptions. Those are some stats that are extremely impressive. And, I mean, this offseason, I was talking about Kyle Trask and how much of a dark horse he was through this offseason and through the 2019 season. And he's definitely showing how much talent that he really has this year, because, I mean, man, it's been a great season for Kyle Trask. He's going to be a tough quarterback to stop moving forward. As for Tennessee, though, they got Garantano, which, I mean, he had a decent start to the season, but ever since, he's been kind of on the downhill. But he's had 1,100 yards, 6 touchdowns and 4 interceptions. So, I mean, he's had a decent season. His accuracy rate is so-so. It's not very good, but, I mean, I definitely think he's able to lead a team to a pretty good season, which, I mean, he's done that in the past. We've seen Tennessee be successful recently. So, I mean, this is just kind of one bad season for the Vols. But as far as it goes for the running back position, of course, you got Pierce on the Florida side, who's had a good season, 400 yards. But Eric Gray on the Tennessee side has had 650 yards with four touchdowns so far this season. He's had a great year for Tennessee, and so he's definitely a player to watch out for if you're on the Florida side. But Florida's got a pretty good rush defense, so that's going to be tough to run against a great Florida defense here. But here's some key points for this one. Florida really is an open chance to make it into the playoff, in my opinion. I mean, there's no doubt on that. I mean, Florida, they got Alabama in their way, which Alabama is going to be a very, very tough team to beat. And I think Florida's going to have to beat the Crimson Tide if they're going to be in the college football playoff this season, which, once again, Alabama's just rolling right now. They're rolling through every single opponent, so that's going to be a tough team to beat. But I think Florida can do it. I think the Gators are looking really good, and I think Kyle Trask is a good enough of a quarterback to be able to take down Mac Jones and that brilliant offense that Alabama has right now. So, I mean, Florida's got a possibility of doing that. They just got to keep winning these games here because, I mean, the season's coming to an end for the SEC before we get into the postseason. It's going to be a crucial game moving forward. Tennessee is trying to break a bad losing streak. No doubt on that. This would really be a helpful win for them in trying to turn around their team because right now, I mean, I'm sure that it's kind of a mess around Tennessee right now. Losing five straight games is never easy. So they're hoping to get a big win here, which honestly for Tennessee, I mean, we've seen them play before and we've seen them play pretty well. So I think Tennessee definitely is capable of having a big win here. But it's just a matter of whether or not they can start fast because that's going to be a big part of this game. If Tennessee can start fast and if they can hold on to a lead through the second half, I mean, that's kind of been the trend for some other teams against Florida is they start fast, they play pretty well in the first half, keep it close, and then the second half, Florida just takes off. And I think for Tennessee, they got to make sure Florida does not take off in the second half, and Tennessee needs to keep it close. But in the end, I've got Florida winning this game. I just think Florida is too good of a team. Kyle Trask is too good of a quarterback to take a loss in this situation. I think we see a 17-7 game at half. We're going to see the same trend as we've seen out of Florida in the past few games. It's going to be kind of a slow start, and it's going to be a low-scoring start, but 17-7 will be our halftime score. Florida's probably going to get a field goal before halftime to put them ahead. Then in the final, 41-21 is going to be the final score. Florida wins it by 20. I think there's a good chance we see Florida win this game by at least three touchdowns. I mean, the Gators are going to be very motivated here. This is a crucial game for them. I mean, I'm sure the committee is going to be especially watching this game because, I mean, you can't forget, Florida's got a game that they lost against Texas A&M on their resume. And considering Texas A&M is right along with Florida right now, I mean, Florida needs every advantage that they can get over Texas A&M right now. And I think Florida is going to be very motivated. They're going to get the win here in the end, 41-21. 80% chance of Florida winning this one, in my opinion. I just think the Gators are too good of a team. They got too good of a defense. They're going to win this game pretty easy. But let me know your thoughts and comments below on this one. Let me know your score predictions, all of that down in the comments. I would like to hear your thoughts on that. Then again, thanks again for watching. Stay tuned for more from All Sports Central. I'll see you all later.